Hi, my name is Jeremy Elliott.
And my name is Matt Wright.
And here we are, going to do a little more medium reading here, just kind of go with the flow and see what happens, who pops in.
Good.
Right now I'm actually getting a vibe of a younger African-American brother, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Chicago, he's from Chicago.
Okay,
I got this very strong, this guy has definitely been through some havoc in his life. Looks like he got shot in his right shoulder, you know, and it led to some internal bleeding or something like that, you know, maybe punctured a lung or something, I don't know.
I see him on the hospital table or some. Never mind.
Yeah,
I'm just telling you, I see it in my head.
Yeah, he was a good soul, though, you know what I'm saying?
Shot right here. Is that what you see?
Right here.
Like, right up here. Yeah, I see the big, like, all right.
Big hole.
Me and Jeremy kind of, like, we see the same things. You know, we kind of go back and forth.
So he's here, and I think he's here to express, you know, what he wants to talk about is gang violence, so. Yeah.
Well, that's one of the things we need to do.
Yeah.
We wanted to do this.
I caught upon this one because I felt like this was something we could definitely use.
Oh, well, all right, let's talk. What's his name? Is he going to give a name this time? Sometimes they don't give names. That's something we see all the time.
A J letter, you know what I'm saying? That doesn't necessarily mean this, that, or that. It could even be a sound. It sounds like J, you know.
Can we call you J?
We'll call him J.
All right.
All right. He said.
All right.
All right. Questions will help me, you know.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, look, Jay, man. You said you want to talk about gangbanging and stuff, man.
Right.
You know, like, what set were you in, man?
Well, we had our own individual set. That's what he's trying to say. Him in Chicago, they just did their own thing. They had something called the Wets or something like this. They did W's. You know what I'm saying? Westside Wets or something like that.
Okay.
You know. And they had the, you know what I mean, the teardrops.
The teardrop tattoos.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the more wet they were, you know, the more bad they were.
Okay.
Okay.
I see what I'm saying, you know.
Uh-huh.
I mean, wet with tattoos.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's what wet meant, like the teardrop, yeah. Number of people killed and whatnot.
Right, right.
I got you. All right. So, I mean, but, what was I going to say? But how long, what year was it that you crossed over?
1984.
All right, so this is back in the...
Yeah, clear as day.
This is back in the 80s. There was a lot of that shit going on back then.
Yeah. You know, they were small, but the thing was, they were just as violent as everybody else. And, it wasn't like he was trying to do anything necessarily, but he wasn't the greatest either. You know, he's got people on that side that he's taking with him, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, I mean, but do y'all hang out on the other side? I mean, talk about, so, you know, enemies that were enemies in this world.
That's
are
right.
Y'all hanging out
yeah,
now?
Yeah, absolutely. That's the whole thing. You know, when he took them with him, you know, he took them before he left, but they're there with him now, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're together, yeah. There's no beef there.
Yeah, we had, you know, Jay, we talked to a couple of dudes from Compton last fall, too. You know, they're talking about something similar, too. You know, talking about that on the other side, you know, Bloods and the Crips were all hanging out, too. You know,
He said, we're all wet over here. You know what I'm saying? This thing, you know, we're all wet. You know.
Yeah, I respect that, man. You know. Because I was like, you know, I really see it, and gangbanging, man, it's just like, it's a family. Like, it's really about family and love. It comes down to that, doesn't it?
It's not.
It comes down to that, you know. People are looking to be accepted somewhere and to get love from someone. Isn't that part of it? That's what I thought.
But part of the gangbanging was, if you know that if you know you disrespected that love, the consequences were so high sometimes that you know it was unnecessary. You know. And that was unfortunate. See, that's what I'm saying. He's not looking at me like this is a positive thing. He's bragging about it all.
He's not like too happy about what happened now.
No, but he's...
But he's happy. He's learned from it.
Right, he's
that's
learned.
That's obvious.
He learned from it, yeah. Definitely. And you know, he's a smooth-looking kid, too, you know. I'm trying to explain to you what he looks like. You know, he's got... Like,
How old were you when you crossed, man?
20-something like that. I see
young.
A 20... But I'm getting confused with the numbers.
All right, let's skip
But he just looks real thin, kind of, you know, and he has a bald head and sharp cheekbones and full lips, you know what I'm saying? He's real like this, you know. He's not wearing no colors or anything.
He's got really no colors in the end.
That's what he's saying. They you know, they could just, they're just all, they blend together. They all blend together.
See, it's like a harmonious continuation from this world. This is dissonant in this world. Different things not meshing, supposedly, but they really do. It's just an illusion, you know. And then the illusion disappears when the moment of death, and you realize what you really are.
Yeah, he sags his pants a little bit.
Well, I mean, do you have any, whatever
he wants. He wants to give props to his moms and his pops. He didn't even know his dad, he said, you know what I'm saying, he said, you know, he's got family, he's got children, you know, he wants to say hello, you know, Jay from the west side of Chicago.
See, like, I mean, yeah, anything else you want to, man, see, like, we always tell people anytime, man, you know, if you ever want to drop in again, man, we're always here, man, you know. I mean, this is one of the things...
He said read Catcher in the Rye.
Yeah, I've heard of that book, you know.
Yeah, I don't know why I said that, man. I have a copy of that book, actually, myself.
Well, tell us about what about that book do you like, man? Or is it just something you think... What is it about it, man? I'm just curious, Jay, you know.
The main character reminds him of himself.
Yeah, I've heard of it. That's a famous book. I mean,
yeah, I know a little bit about it.
I've never read it, but
I know. I don't want to say about the story either, so I'm not going to say.
All right.
I don't know the whole thing either. You know, maybe it's a little interesting to find out.
Well, the book was considered obscene back when it came out. Like, they tried to have the book banned because it talked about sex and had cuss words in it.
Okay.
And
I don't know all that, because I think I read maybe a chapter, you know what I mean, of that book, so I don't know. But.
He just got caught up in the light. He was born in that place and time, certain ways, certain neighborhoods, places you live, you get caught up in things like this.
Sometimes. I don't know why I said to read the Catcher in the Rye. He showed me like that.
He's showing it. I see him showing the cover and stuff back and forth.
You know, he said, hey, and read the Catcher in the Rye.
We'll read it today. I mean, I'll read it when I get home today. I mean, you made me want to read it now, Jay. All the times I heard about it.
All right,
brother, man. We appreciate this, man.
Thank you, dude. That was a good one.
That was.
I like him.
Oh, yeah.
He's a good guy. That guy I can hang out with right now, you know what I mean?
Me too. I feel that it's a positive vibe.
Yeah, he's a cool dude. All right.
Well,
you got that one right.
All right. That was good. It might have run over 10 minutes, but, you know, let's look for part two. If we had ran over 10 minutes, you'll know where to go on these video sites. But I just wanted to say, like, you know, we jump from thing to thing. You know, we might talk 1 minute. It might be John Belushi or Tupac or somebody like that. Next minute, you know, somebody just living an ordinary life, you know, but we're open for anybody, and I've always said that, you know.
We're really hoping that one day Michael Jackson will pop through.
He's probably a little busy on the other side, but we've talked to him, too. He'll come.
He will come.
He will.
All right.
All right. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more soon.
All right.